Last time I finished by making a comparison between bird and bull. Bird was writing music for music's sake. Bird makes music speak, and he makes music speak through him, not himself speak through music. Well, bull makes himself speak through music. The emotions in his writing seem really personal. There's force and there's vulnerability, force in the single-mindedness of purpose, which makes his music captivating and sometimes fantastically annoying, and vulnerability in that it's not trying to be the most perfect way of saying something. He'll write an idea as it comes to him, not the distilled version of the idea after having thought a whole lifetime about how to formulate it most perfectly. And when sometimes his music makes no sense, it moves us by evoking how life sometimes makes no sense. Ever since the 19th century, we know that this feeling is part of what music can be. And it moves us in a special way because it's real. It's like in a film. You don't want to make every single sentence of dialogue as epic as it can possibly be. You actually want the audience to take part in the journey that the character is going through, not just present a fully expressed end result. Queen Elizabeth's Pavan is probably an elegy upon the death of Queen Elizabeth I in 1603. A pavan, a dance form, traditionally has three sections. And here it seems that the first of these sections represents a kind of lamentation. We hear the long descending lines drooping like sighs and the wavering, shivering trills. The second section of the pavan seems to be some kind of depiction of pain through chromaticism. And in the third, we get a transfiguration, like an intensely bright pealing of bells. It is a trope that, of course, we see a lot in the literature of all time periods, the funeral triumph. Bull's life is split into two sections. In his later years, he moved to Antwerp. Actually, he apparently had to flee England because he was in big trouble, which I won't go into because it's not my place to judge him now. Whatever the circumstances, his musical personality was also transformed. That which was angry became resigned, and the fire in his music turned to a kind of radiance, and pride gave way to a hidden sorrow. In the Netherlands, he might have gotten close to the famous musician Sweelinck. In any case, their music shows a lot of interesting parallels, similarities, and influences. Right after Sweelinck died in 1621, Bull wrote a fugue on a theme by Sweelinck. It's a remarkable piece. So here's the theme by Sweelinck. It's like the theme has become for Bull the person, and it keeps showing up, rematerializing in different forms here and there. Actually, it completely pervades the fugue. As the fugue goes on, all these instances give us the feeling that wherever we look, the theme is there. I imagine it like an oral depiction of a memory haunting a sleepless night. Towards the end, the music starts building up in waves. It's like it really wants to get to the Transfiguration, like in Queen Elizabeth's Tavern, but it can't get there. It sinks back down. And this leads to a very different kind of ending with bells. It's a single bell in the middle of nowhere, fading into nothing. The difference between these designs, in addition to reflecting how Bull changed as a person in the intervening time between 1603 and 1621, seems also fitting for that this one should be an elegy for a friend, and the other one a public ceremony. The most moving elegy by Bull may be the one that, from posterity's perspective, he wrote for himself. When he died, a music scribe gathered up the loose papers and wrote down everything he found. Among these things were a bunch of pieces based on Gregorian chant. Many of them are actually canons. Bull in his life wrote a lot of canons. They were like a diary of all the weird, clever, and unbelievable things he could do in music. But here they're reduced to the essence, to the most simple kind of canon. It feels to me like the chant, Telluris Ingens Conditor, represents eternity, while the canon, a symbol of compositional art and ingenuity, represents the human spirit, or the spirit of Bull as a composer. And here they come together in this piece of music. I can't prove the story, but it fits the work and it fits my image of this unforgettable personality that was John Bull.